Hi and welcome everyone, Lisa here. Thanks for joining me for another card video. Today I'm sharing a few fun cards featuring CAS-ual, Fri-Die's Love Notes stamp set and the Love Note Fri-Die that matches this set. I'm going to be doing a couple of techniques using alcohol inks, and we're also going to do some partial die cutting. So let's just go ahead and get started. So I have the big kick sitting here, and we're going to be using 80-pound Nina Classic Crest Solar White cardstock and a plain rectangle die. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut a solid cardstock panel so that we can use it to create a frame with our floating love note. And you'll notice I gave that die and paper a little twist before I ran it through. It helps to eliminate warping of your plates when you do that. A lot of times if you run the die straight in, you'll get that hard crank and that loud crack, and that's when your plates start to warp. So just give it a little twist and you'll notice a big difference. Okay, so I'm grabbing a smaller rectangle die and I'm centering it up. Now I'm not going to cut it yet because I'm just doing this so I can figure out where I'm going to place my love note. And I'm placing mine in the upper right hand corner, and I'm going to take a piece of post-it tape and secure it down. And then I'm going to move that rectangle die out of the way. I use, for partial die cutting, I have some smaller plates that are actually for a smaller machine, but they work perfect for partial die cutting. And what you want to do is just run the plate to where you want to stop cutting. Wherever you want your love note not cut, don't put the plate there, okay? Because you don't want to apply pressure, because the pressure is what causes the die to cut. So stop the plate wherever you want to stop cutting. And you'll see there that once I remove the love note die, that it's not cut completely. All right, so here we go. I'm centering it up, and then I'm going to add my post-it tape to it, and then we're going to run it through the machine. So this is one of those times where I'm going to try to give it a little twist the best that I can. It might not work out that way. So we're going to run it through. And then we're going to flip it around and we're going to run it through again, making sure not to cut where our love note is attached to the frame. So partial die cutting is really simple if you just take your time and play around with it at first, get a feel for how you want to, you know, is going to work for you. It shouldn't be difficult at all. It's really easy process. Okay, so now you're going to see here that I'm going to carefully peel that post-it tape off and remove this frame. Now you're going to have to do a little bit of snipping with your scissors, and I noticed there was a small place down here at the bottom where it didn't cut all the way through. So I'm just going to take my scissors and just snip that, and then you see there's your floating love note. Okay, so let's talk alcohol inks. Alcohol inks are not quite as easy as everybody makes them out to be. You have to learn how to just let go. So for me, it was a little difficult, but I finally sat down and was determined that I was going to use these alcohol inks. It was the last thing I did. And I played around with some the night before doing this video, and I found a couple of things that helped me. One was if I left some white space. I like a lot of white space on my cards, so if I left some white space or very light colored spaces, then I seem to like it better. I also found that the blending tools and the felt paper are not my cup of tea. As of right now. Now that's not to say that I won't make myself sit down and play with those also and get a feel for them, but as of right now, I don't like the blending tools with the felt for alcohol inks. I use the 91% alcohol. You can pick it up in any big box store, and you want to be sure that you work in a well-ventilated area so that you don't become overwhelmed with that 91% alcohol. The inks aren't so bad, but if you're using the 91% alcohol, it can get a little bit strong. So you just want to keep that in mind. since I didn't use the blending tools, I find I like using paint brushes. So I'm just using some inexpensive Crayola paint brushes for this, and I clean them and keep them with my alcohol inks so that I can use them again. I find also that if I work with colors that work well together, then I end up with better results. I don't end up with anything too muddy. So when I use colors like blues and turquoise and greens and yellows together, or purple and pink and blue together, reds, orange, and yellows together, stuff like that, I have better results. A couple of times I tried to do some that were a little bit, you know, being creative, and yeah, they were not pretty at all. So if you're just starting out with alcohol inks, I recommend that you stay in color groups that work well together. And after you get a feel for it, and then I would say adventure out some. Okay, so for this one here that you see me doing, the first one, the colors I used were Sailboat, Mermaid, Citrus, Dandelion, and I did use some gold mixative with it. For this one here that I'm doing, I used Sailboat Blue, Amethyst, Salmon, Flamingo, and Rose Gold. Now, this Rose Gold is absolutely gorgeous. I'm not kidding. I love it. And you can get it in a pack, and it comes with gunmetal also. And the gunmetal is awesome for galaxies. So I played around, and I did a galaxy, and I really, really liked the way it turned out. So I used the gunmetal to create the galaxy, and then I flicked it with silver. And man, I love it. So I'll show that in another video, though. So here we are. I've finished this up, and I'm ready to start assembling. So remember, when you're working with alcohol inks, just to have fun with them. Don't take it so serious. So here we are. My YUPO paper is dry. I'm cutting it to fit the back of our die cut frames that we created at the beginning of the video with a partial die cut. And I'm going to tell you this. If you don't like partial die cutting, stick around, because I actually make one of these cards without partial die cutting. I decided to do just a regular frame. For those of you who don't want to try partial die cutting or just can't get the hang of it, I did a regular frame, and I cut out some colored love notes from the Love Note Fri-Die, and we're going to play around with those. Okay, so here we have our frames and our YUPO paper ready. I have some 3D mounting foam over to the side that we're going to add to the back. So I'm just taking some of the 3D mounting foam, cutting it in half, and I'm going to go around the frames, and I'm even going to put some on the back of the heart to hold it up too. Okay, so we've got our frames all done and ready to be used. So I'm going to start adding some embellishments to these cards to kind of bring them to life. So here I have two of the die cut love notes and different shades of purple, and I'm just offsetting them on that white love note there. Once I'm through with this, I just set some acrylic blocks on top of it to the side and let it dry while I move on. Earlier, I talked about doing one of these cards without doing partial die cutting. So here we are. We have our plain white frame there, and we have some colored love notes already cut out. I'm just going to play around with this and see where I want the colored love notes to go, and I'm going to be using three of them. I'm using the summer lime and the Audrey blue and the banana color. So once I decide where I want them, I'm going to add some quick dry adhesive to the back of them and some small pieces of the 3D foam wherever I need it to secure them. And then I'm going to put some acrylic blocks on the top of that and set it to the side and let it dry. While we have these setting to the side and letting them dry, we're going to go ahead and take the rest of those colored love notes and stack them one on top of the other, and then we're going to add those to this card here. So I just go green, yellow, blue, green, yellow, blue, some order like that. And so when you're looking at the card from the side, you'll actually see those colors stacked on top of each other. It's really pretty. Okay, so now we're ready to start doing our stamping, and I'm using the sentiment, just a note, from the Love Note stamp set. And I'm going to start with Audrey Blue up at the top by that yellow note. And then I'm going to use the soft vanilla down by the green note. And we're going to give the sentiment a twist and do it on the top left above that Audrey Blue note with the lime green ink. Now you can stamp your sentiments however you want. It's completely up to you. So now we're just going to go ahead and adhere these to our card bases. And our card bases are 110-pound Nina Classic Crest Solar White cardstock. And I just add some adhesive to the back of them using my ATG gun and center them on the card base. Once we have them centered on the card base, then we're going to start adding some more embellishments to them. So I have some little sparkly gems that I'm going to add to a couple of them, and then we're going to play around with some sequins with the others and see what happens. So once you finish with your sequins and your other embellishments, you're done. And so here's the card that started it all. I sat down the night before, like I said earlier, and played with alcohol inks in a way that worked for me. So going light with them is what really got me started with them, and I really enjoy them now. So this one I kept really simple. I didn't even add embellishments to it. I just did the partial die cutting and added sentiment and added it to the card base. This is the one where you don't have to do the partial die cutting. You can actually just die cut the love notes and place them around the frame of the card. And this is the one where we stacked all the love notes together to have the colors. As you've turned the card, you can see all those colors stacked on top of each other. And this is the favorite. Here we go. I absolutely love this one. This is the amethyst and flamingo salmon sailboat blue with the rose gold. It turned out so pretty. I'm telling you guys, that rose gold is amazing. So again, it's just a matter of just letting go and having fun with the alcohol inks. Try different techniques. Use paintbrushes instead of blenders if they don't work for you. Try some 91% alcohol. Just whatever would work for you. Just play around with them and have fun with them. But don't give up on them. Keep playing with them until you get the hang of it. So I hope you enjoyed this video. And I sure do appreciate all of you. And until the next time, take care and keep crafting.